Hey there, Church. Back with another update video. And this week, I want to talk to you about something that I'm hesitant to talk about, but that I feel the need to address. And that is something that we've seen in the news a lot lately. And that is the churches in our province who are getting a lot of media attention for the decisions they're making and the paths they're going on. Of course, you probably know I'm talking about Grace Church in Edmonton and Street Church in Calgary. And maybe you're wondering where we stand as a church, where we stand as church leadership on this, and how come we're not making some of the same decisions and pursuing some of the same tactics that we see have been exhibited by those churches. And I want to address that today. And I want to help you to understand not just what we're doing, but why we're doing it. And as always, I want to just begin by saying if you have any questions, if you have any comments, if you have any thoughts about this video, please reach out to me. Please email me, please text me, please phone me. However you want to contact me, please, I would absolutely welcome it. As I think about addressing this, I can't help but begin by thinking about the words of Jesus when he says, "Be wise as serpents and innocent as doves." And there's a tension in that advice that Jesus gives that we need to embrace, where we need to be thinking shrewdly and acting shrewdly, but need to be doing it not for selfish purposes. And I think that many times the church has got half of that right, either dealt with things very shrewdly or been very sacrificial, but not put the two together and acted shrewdly in a selfless manner. That's what we see demonstrated in the life of Jesus. And as always, everything that Jesus calls us to do, he models himself. He walked in wisdom, but he also walked in selfless, sacrificial love, and he calls us to do the same. And so it's because of that that I can't help but think about our vision statement and how do we best fulfill our vision statement in light of all the decisions that we have to make through this pandemic. And we have had to make decisions and then change decisions and then change decisions again as the restrictions have changed and the situations and circumstances have changed. And yet, through it all, we've continued to embrace and the pursuit of this idea of shrewdly using wisdom in a selfless manner. And that endeavor, that pursuit, has brought us to the place where I want you to know that we, as a leadership team, and I talked this over with the board before doing this video, and as I share this video with you, I'm sharing you not just Doug's opinion, but also the consensus of the board and of the staff of this church. And that is, we don't agree that the path that Grace Church and that Street Church have taken is the right one. Looking at shrewdly, selflessly assessing every situation, and looking at our vision statement of imaging Jesus by becoming love, how can we best during this pandemic shrewdly, selflessly image Jesus by becoming love? And the answer to that is not to fight for our rights. And I believe that the churches that are in this pursuit of the fighting for their rights and that are in this fight for defending what the Constitution has told them they could have may be dealing shrewdly, but they're not doing it in a selfless way. And maybe even there's a selflessness to some of them because they want to worship Jesus, but they're not thinking shrewdly. They're not thinking about the fact that the world is looking at what they see on the news of the church, and they're not seeing people who are modeling the way of Jesus in selflessly, sacrificially laying down their rights. They're seeing people who are militantly demanding their rights at the expense of their neighbor, not seeking to love their neighbor. And so for us as leadership of this church, we have had to wrestle many times through what do we do? How do we respond? And in every one of those decisions, what we have always endeavored to do is to say, how do we best image Jesus by becoming love? How do we best demonstrate to this city of Airdrie, who we love and who we are called to love, the image of Jesus that says, you are more important than me? And if we choose to say we're going to gather and we're going to sing and we're going to worship and we're going to disregard all health restrictions and we're going to disregard all of the things that have been imposed upon us because we have a right to do that because of our Constitution, we may win that battle, but we will ultimately lose the war of showing, not the war, lose the opportunity, because it's not a war, to show the love of Jesus to our city. And that is what drives us as a leadership team. And so I know there's been a lot of publicity in the news for those churches, and I don't know where you stand on it. You may be in complete agreement with them. You may have a heart that grieves as you look at what they're doing and you think about how your neighbors and how your friends and how your coworkers and how the people you go to school with are seeing the church in this season. Our hope and our desire and where we're trying to lead Living Springs is in a path that says we need to, because Jesus told us to, lay down our own rights and fight for the rights of others. That's not just what Jesus told us to do. That's how Jesus lived. Ultimately, causing him to go to the cross where he died, not for himself, but for us. And he calls us now to lay down our rights for our neighbors. Wherever you are on this pandemic, whatever your opinion, your thoughts, and I know there are many of them, whatever they are, surely we can understand that we are called to love our neighbor. There is nothing that the world needs to see now more than the sacrificial love of Christ demonstrated by the church. We live in divisive times. We live in times where people will divide ideologically, divide politically, divide culturally at seems like the drop of a hat. And we need to be people who reach across those divides to share the love of Jesus with people. And that is why we have chosen to go a different way. And that's why we disagree with the path that those pastors have taken. I hope wherever you are, you can understand the reasoning behind the path we've taken. And your heart is with us in demonstrating the love of Jesus corporately and individually to our city. That's all for this week. I'll be back sometime soon with another update. But in the meantime, can I just encourage you to continue to image Jesus by becoming love? As I said at the beginning, if you have any questions, please feel free to email, text, or phone me. I would love to hear from you. We'll talk to you again soon.